Good morning. So last time we were looking at the add measurements form, and had decided that we need to do something different with its CSS to get it displayed properly. So I think today I'll be playing with different ways of showing it. Flex grid. I think possibly grid is the way to go. But I need to experiment with it and see. So I'm going to try with that first. So let's see where we are. Okay, I need to make sure everything's up and running. Okay. Okay, all the servers are up and running. And what were we left with last week? I think I had just put it back to basics here. Okay. So let's have a look at the code and see what we can do to reformat that extra form there. Oh, I still haven't updated that, have I? I'll do a quick update there. I not need to restart? Let's do a quick, yeah. Okay. So, what have we got? Let's get rid of some of this extra stuff. So, we've still got a bunch of forms using the form component. We may or may not stop doing that. We'll see. It's very simple. I don't really know if I need it. So the add measurement. So we've got this global form stuff here, which I think we're going to have to override. So at the moment we're doing maximum width and some old school manipulation of the form just to keep it within that block. But I think we're going to be switching that out to grid or flex. So let's see if we can override this. We should just make sure that is up to date. Yeah, nothing to do. So add some style. Gonna display grid. And I think for the beginning, we're gonna set it to width 100%. I'll just see how with that excuse me. And I'll see whether that does anything yet. Because I might need to remove all the global stuff. Pretty sure I do. Yeah, it's still been overridden. So yeah, I've still got the max width and stuff going on there. So I'm going to take that out. I guess there is a quick and easy way around that. I could make sure this is only applying to a particular class. But I kind of feel like I'm going to redo all the forms anyway. So let's nuke it. Let's get rid of that stuff. And I think I'll be potentially updating all of the label set out as well. So we'll just do this for the moment and then actually, it's just let's be a little bit careful about this. Let's keep this and then this might be okay. Because once it's in a grid, everything changes. Let's see what that does. That's all right. It's interesting that label hasn't done its thing there, but that one has. I guess because of the width. So I'm assuming the clear isn't working at all. Yeah, because it works in there. Yeah, so that's normal document flow there with a label, which is width 100. And an input, again, width 100. So that's fine. Okay, we'll come back to them. And then here, this up a bit, really. There we go. Fine, we'll deal with that later. Okay. So let's start putting this into something usable. If we do grid template columns, what have we got there? We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, and then a couple of buttons. I think we could possibly get away with three columns. So we have the goal, when it's on desktop, the goal, the value, the date taken, and then we have notes underneath. Maybe taken up two. And then possibly just a big save button, because I don't think we really need a cancel button. Not in the way I'm going to be setting it out. So let's try that. So grid columns. Are we going to have different widths? The value and the date taken are fairly small. So if I did repeat 3, 1, bar. I'd get three of them. Let's stick in a bit of gap. What should we do? Let's just do one rem. Just so we can see what's what. I wonder if we should set a height. And a position. bottom zero. Why is it running off? Is that because I've now broken it? Yeah, it's not going to do anything, is it? Ooh. Does not like that, does it? They do not interact well. That'd be interesting. Okay, we might have to stick a container around that. So that we can position it. And then do a grid inside. But, okay. Right, let's do... I think we're going to get rid of the button there. And we're going to do that as... two. All right, let's go have a play. So, what do we have? Grid template columns. I might. Yeah, I'll keep that for the moment. And take that for the moment. I think I might come back to that. I think the cancel button possibly needs to be just used to collapse the slider as such. Eventually. Okay, now comes the interesting bit because... have a text area that's in the sub component. Don't know if this is going to work. Might not work. So I've got three, so that means I want to go from the first line, second line, third line. But I have a feeling it's not going to apply, because I've got it in a subcomponent. I don't really want to do the global stuff. Yeah. Okay. Edit cap. Yes. Does this work? I've been using named. Nothing yet. Okay. Because I could do that. Oops. Still not going to pick up that. What I don't want to get to is having components which know too much about the container. So I don't want to be going into the measurement input and saying, hey, I'm going to stretch across two grid columns for the notes. The alternative is I use global, which I don't know if I've used that before. I have. Not great. Really wanted to keep it nice and componentized, but I might not be able to. I might need to just use this as is and have a little bit of duplication. I mean, the thing is, how often am I going to be using the add the measurement form? I can't. See, I expected to use the measurement input component when editing a measurement as well. So I really kind of want to keep it as is. Let's see. I can't really think of another way around that. It did not work. Oh, did I do? actually implement anything? I did. Oh, I didn't pass through the class. Okay. Oh, I don't have a container anyway. Okay. Think I'll so that'll basically make the div disappear, but I can pass through some classes. So export class equal what's it? It's props. Can't remember. Props, just classes. I think I need to do a test to see whether it exists actually. I've quite a look at the docs in a sec. Otherwise, all that. So this is what I kind of want to do. If I'm setting some classes, why is that complaining? Yeah, because that should be class. Yeah, so if we've got classes, slap that in there. Because I don't think we can pass through class at the moment. Can we? I think that changed actually recently. I wonder. Yeah, because I'm pretty sure it changed. Originally, you could not pass in class because it was default property. No, I've got that. So I could use rest props. In which case, I could probably get shot at that. Okay, that's better. Don't need to do with that. So I'm guessing I'm using the same there, because I think in all my forms it's always going to be label and input, so let's just make sure these bits work. It's just basic input handling there. I think that's fine. So here I'm given that measurement input class, and then explicitly saying that the notes label should stretch between over the first two grids that I've defined here. Okay, getting there. So what if we kind of want a bit more style like this? I'll whack up the font size. Mind you, that's a completely different control. A bit janky in its position. Let's give it an ID. Is that allowed? See what mess this makes. Probably should have tried this in the browser. But once I've got that, I can start mucking about with it. Did not like it. Yeah, strips it out. I thought it might. Okay. Is that rather large? Can't even see it. That's diffraction. Oh wow. What's going on with the padding? Why is it capitalized? Yeah, I had to do other. But that should already have that. Okay. Could do. Water rose. What's a good height? What's the height at the moment? Okay. I will adjust the height. Oops. Think I just moved something. Ah. Do min max. Don't know if that works. It's not really doing what I want. Although I don't really know what I want. Let's think about that. Oh, gotta go. Got a meeting. Right. Yeah. So I've just been playing really with what might or might not work, and that's giving me something to think about. Anyway, I'm not sure what I'm gonna do there. I might end up putting the buttons underneath in like two separate columns if I add a couple. I don't know. Still undecided as to whether this is even the right place to put the ad measurement stuff. We'll see. Have another go tomorrow. Not tomorrow. Got a couple of days I'm not working, so it's going to be a little bit. But, until next time, take care. Bye.